Hey fellow tennis nerds, welcome to the Diadem Elevate Tour and Diadem Nova 100 Racket Review. This review deals with the FS version, which is the flex stabilization system that they've added now into this racket. The Nova is a pure drive style racket made for recreational players ranging from intermediate to lower level advanced perhaps. It's much lighter and easier to use, a bit stiffer as well for more power, has an open string pattern of 16-19. While the Elevate and Elevate Tour is a more control-oriented racket, more like a blade, 98 square inches, 16-20 string pattern, which is a good balance of spin and control, and a slightly lower stiffness rating. So that racket, the Elevate, is more for advanced players, and the Nova is more for players who need help with power and spin. Let's start with the Diadem FS Nova. So the Nova is a 100 square inch racket, 300 gram unstrung weight, 32 centimeter balance or 7 points head light. It's a standard length, so 27 inches or 68.58 centimeters. Has a stiffness rating unstrung of 69 RA, so definitely a bit more flexible than a pure drive. And if you string it, it's gonna go down to 66. And the string pattern is 16-19, which is kind of standard with these 100 square inch rackets these days. The beam is 23.5 millimeter flat beam, which means it's not as thick as some other tweener frames on the market. That makes it a bit faster through the air, it's a bit easier to swing, and that's a part of the racket I really liked. Also, the dampening of this frame is really good. You feel 100% connected to the ball, especially at the net. I really loved it on volleys, even in stock form. And it's still really responsive and not stiff to hurt your arm. So I thought the Nova really surprised me. I thought it would be just another Pure Drive clone, but it actually played nicer than a Pure Drive to me, with a thinner beam and the lower stiffness rating. It's definitely a more comfortable, kind of the first iteration of the Pure Drive, which is the one I like the most. So this one really felt spot on. It did come in at a really low swing weight for me, so I measured it at 305, strung with Diadem Solstice Power, which is their star-shaped string that they got famous for, Diadem. And the swing weight was really low, so 305. It still played pretty good power, but the stability was a bit lacking, so I ended up adding lead tape to it, only 4 grams at 10 and 2 o'clock in the hoop, and that really made the racket a lot more stable and a lot easier for me to play, at least, and it could handle pace from the opponent much better. These kind of rackets should be up in the 320 range strung to be really stable and still maneuverable. That's my opinion about the swing weight. But the racket is really nice to play with, handles slice really well. It's not a crazy launch angle of any kind with the 16-19 string pattern, so pretty controlled. Sweet spot is definitely large. I felt like it was one of the easiest rackets I've used in a while. So if you're looking for these kind of tweener frames and you want a racket that's easy to use, gives you some power but doesn't really hurt your arm, I think Diadem Nova should be on your list, because this one really surprised me with the ease of use and the playability and also the feel, because I really felt more connected to the ball here than I do with most of these tweener frames that are stiffer, gives you easier access to power and spin, but you have the detriment of not getting that feel and connection to the ball. But this one actually did that, but it did need some lead tape. Perhaps I just got a low spec racket, and that's, as you know, that's the case with most manufacturers, that you really need to make sure you get somewhere within the spec range, because some of these rackets can really be outside of it, and then it's got a completely different racket to start with. But this one played fine in a low swing weight, but much better when I added some weight to it. There are three technologies at work here. It's Impact Shield, which was in the previous generation. That the idea is to deflect harmful shock and contact and reduce overall vibration. It's basically some kind of foam filling in the racket, and it really seems to work because these rackets are very comfortable and stable. It's also a high modulus carbon, creates kind of a uniform flex, so it flexes uniformly across the racket. And it has what's new for this generation of the Nova is the flex stabilization system. It's a patent-pending rib system throughout the frame. It really seems to work well. I really felt 100% connected. It was very comfortable to play with, especially for these kind of frames, which are usually a bit too stiff for many players. But this one is one of my favorite tweener frames I've tested in a long time. and I could easily start using this frame with some small customization to make it up into kind of my wheelhouse of rackets. But really nice frame from Diadem, and I'm impressed that such a young company can come out and create these high quality products, and they seem to be doing really well from what I can see in here around the tennis world. So well done for the Nova. It was a positive surprise for me. Really enjoyable frame, just very well connected to the ball, pretty good pace on serves as these rackets usually offer. But the most appealing part of this racket was that I could really feel connected on volleys and touch shots, and I felt like I could play both with power and more creatively, which is what I'm looking for in a frame. So well done on the new FS Nova 100. If we look at the Diadem Elevate Tour, that's a completely different beast in a way. Smaller head size, 98 square inches. It's a 1620 string pattern, which is one of my favorite patterns because it offers you a bit more directional control, but still pretty good spin thanks to the 16 mains. It has a weight of 315 grams unstrung. So this is the Tour version. There's also the regular version, which is 305. It's a bit easier to swing and use, but a bit less stable. The balance is 31.5 centimeters, which gives it a pretty maneuverable feel. The technology is the same as the Nova, the FS for the flex stabilization system, and it has impact shield to dampen vibration, and it's definitely foam filled, which creates a really stable, solid feel. Makes it a bit more tough to swing for some players maybe, but it's just really really stable on impact, has a really nice and plush feel. This racket is a very, very nice frame for advanced players, I think. I was enjoying it almost as much as the Nova, but the Nova was surprisingly my favorite. I think I've come to terms that I'm not the kind of tennis player I should be, so I'm gravitating more towards easy-to-use rackets. But this one was very user-friendly for a tour-style frame. I tested it alongside the Pure Strike Tour, and I enjoyed these both. I think they offered similar stability. This one offered a nicer feel, but a bit less power. So if you're an advanced player who like to play with a stable and efficient racket that you can create some good power with, but you require a bit more technique to swing it, I think you should check out the Elevate Tour. It's a really nice frame. I'm quite impressed by Diadem and that they can shell out these frames and that they don't do too many of them, that it's not too many models to choose from in their range. They focus on making a high quality and fewer versions, which should appeal to customers who don't want to get lost in the racket jungle. Really nice frame, I felt super connected to it, and the string pattern offers pretty good spin. Still get some good power from this racket because the stiffness rating is around mid-60s when strung, so 67 unstrung. Still pretty headlight and maneuverable. It's very hard to fault this frame. I didn't feel, it's just like a very solid, nice playing frame with above average comfort. Should be a strong competitor to the Blade and other popular rackets such as the Pure Strike 98 square rackets that people use. Plays pretty similar to the Technifiber TF40, which is very high praise. Both offer some kind of plushness, but still a good mix of control and power, so I think these rackets really can fit quite a wide group of more advanced players. So if you're a really advanced junior or a player who likes a bit more heft to your frame, check out the Tour version. If you just want a more controlled, very close to a Blade style racket, you could go for the Elevate normal 98 version. But top-notch frame, couldn't really fault it anywhere. I strung it with the new string Diadem Elite XT at around 23 kilos or 51 pounds, which I felt worked really well to still get control from the frame and offer a good feel and a bit of pocketing effect from the string bed. Both of these rackets strung with Diadem strings actually performed really well, and I'm very happy with them. So well done for both of these frames to Diadem Sports. That's all for this Tennis Nerd Racket Review. I hope you enjoyed it. Please click like, share it with your tennis friends, and subscribe to the channel. Every little bit helps to grow the Tennis Nerd tribe. If you need help choosing a racket, because it's a jungle out there, please check out our racket consultation service in the Tennis Nerd shop. tennisnerd.net/shop. We also offer plenty of content that's not available on tennisnerd.net on our Patreon page, patreon.com/tennisnerd. You can go in there. It's only $2 a month to subscribe, and you get unique content, and there's also a chat function that you can use, and you get no ads as well, so there's a lot of benefits to that. That's all for now. Have a nice day. Take care, and don't forget to play some tennis.